Yeah, we've kind of struggled to get people to, like, hashtag the store or post stuff about the store afterwards, where you see, like, everybody's always, before they can eat it, they got to take a picture of it. No, like, and it's like, we need to make a movement where it's like, before you wear it, lay it down, take a picture of it.
Yeah, but, that would be dope.
Yeah, it's, I think the food movement definitely helps, though, because you have to have those anchors. Mm-hmm. And so when people come out to eat locally, then that kind of pushes forward that mentality. And then they wind up walking down to the shop. It's down the strip. So the more local food, the better. We're we're hitting it hard with the local food right now. I'd love to see more retail, too.
Yeah.
But
that's the same boat I'm in.
With that,
see more retail, it just changed the whole mindset of the city. Yeah. People already look at it like, I got to go eat locally. But when people start saying, I got to go shop locally, whether it's even groceries or whatever else it is, I think it'll change a lot and it'll put a lot more money into the city.
Really, really want to support local designers and local artists and all of that. You've got to cut it off. You either have to shop vintage if you can't afford to shop locally, or you have to shop locally, or it's going to continue. Like, we have to, the movement really has to keep moving forward. And it's, I guess, for like American jobs, or from a job standpoint, it's going to stink, but all those jobs are going to trickle down. Like, we'll be able to hire more people if the H&M closes. And that's really what I hope for, is that we see to go like apocalyptic with it. Like, we see more malls closing. And we see that huddle mentality, like, to where it, that would just completely support local businesses, because people would get used to driving that extra 5-10 minutes to go see somebody. And I think it's happening.